Amazing.
Thank you.
driving all the way to New York to see them play. Right, Zach?
It took us hours to get to New York by bus. We got to the CBGB and we were so nervous we couldn't go inside.
It took us 30 minutes to gather enough courage to go inside. And inside, we were shocked. Right, Zach?
I'll never forget that feeling. It was like a blitzkrieg. Blitzkrieg pop.
The Ramones.
That song still makes me feel good. And that's a sign of a classic. But it's amazing I got in without being asked for ID. Those were the good old days. Rock and roll high school and Chinese rock. Sheena is a punk rocker and surfing bird. And I was so depressed when I heard the news of the deaths. Original punk is one of the greatest gifts left from the 20th century. Let's hope they're still rocking on, wherever they are.
Mr. Francis York Morgan, finally you have arrived. You are welcome to come inside.
Mr. Francis York Morgan, Mr. Stewart has been waiting for you. To the meeting room you shall go to.
The meeting room is through here. Please be kind. Be sincere.
Mr. Francis York Morgan, please have some tea while it is hot. Too much coffee for your body will make it rot.
You seem well prepared. Almost as though you knew I would be coming today.
Mr. Stewart is particular about the best timing for all things. Now please, drink some tea and enjoy the good health it brings.
I'm sorry, Harry, but I just don't like tea.
Mr. Francis York Morgan, some tea with sugar is what's best admired. By your body that looks so tired, so says Mr. Stewart.
Harry, where did you get these seeds?
Mr. Francis York Morgan, those seeds were found in our town, in a certain specific place.
More seeds are there, you will see, when you find that certain space. Come back to me and we shall talk, after you find that certain place. So says Mr. Stewart.
Harry, so you like to play games?
Mr. Francis York Morgan, a hint for you to find this location.
It is most crowded and most quiet, and gives a cold sensation. So says Mr. Stewart.
All right. So you're not going to talk unless I find this certain place. I'll play along. Zack, let the treasure hunt begin. A crowded place, and yet it is very quiet there.
Have you figured it out, Zach? Must be the graveyard. There's lots of people there, but none of them can speak. You see? So let's get going to the graveyard.
Just as Harry said, it's crowded and quiet. Hey, Brian.
Agent! Mr. Agent, how are you?
Not bad. I'm just playing a little game with Harry.
Game? A game? Is that fun?
We've only just started, Brian. The fun is about to begin. I'd like to ask you something, actually. Is there a tree in the graveyard that drops red seeds?
Seeds? Red seeds? That tree does. And that one. And that one, too. All red seeds.
Yeah.
Zack, mission accomplished. Let's get back to Harry's. The reward better be good.
But you know, about these seeds. They were right here under my nose. It's as if I was carefully carrying a bottle of water while walking in a pool.
We're learning the countryside version of common sense the hard way, Zack.
Mr. Francis York Morgan, finally you have arrived. You are welcome to come inside.
Mr. Francis York Morgan, please proceed to Mr. Stewart's room. There he awaits you, I shall assume.
Huh?
Harry, turns out what you said was true, and I'd like to hear more.
York, as you know, there's a powerful mystery surrounding these seeds. You've seen them at those other murders that took place elsewhere. And you've seen them deeply involved with the murders in this town.
That's right. But how do you know all this?
York, you must be younger than you look. Youngsters tend to hurry so much that they let things slip right past them.
What you need to do is slow this down a bit. That way you'll see what's really important. Let me tell you a story. 50 years ago, when the war was over, just about when the Communist Red started to become a rising threat, our town constructed a huge clock tower. Then, soon afterwards, a serial killer wearing a red raincoat went on a killing spree.
The legend of the Raincoat Killer? Stop playing games with me, Harry. That's nothing more than folklore. The FBI has no such record of a multiple homicide case in this town.
York, Anna, Becky, and now Diane. Their deaths are real, not folklore, not legend.
The Raincoat Killer is also real. Under a strict gag order, the mass murder case was never made public. In fact, one could say that it was completely erased from history. Tell me, who do you think would be able to do something like that?
The military.
Very good.
But if there are no records about it, then how do you know it really happened?
Good question, York. Why would I know this? The answer is very simple. I was there.
I saw it with my own eyes. The brutal killer himself. But we can talk about the details of that encounter another time. What we need to talk about is your Raincoat Killer. The new Raincoat Killer, if you will. The new Raincoat Killer. Yes, let's call him that. After all, he's not the real one. What you want to know more about noticed that these red seeds were special. And someone else did too. The human imagination can lead to tragedy sometimes. Someone linked the red seeds to the serial killer legend and said, if you eat the red seeds and then kill someone, you will become immortal. This new fabricated legend was passed on from one to the next, evolving and changing every time, like a rumor. Some may have actually taken the seeds to try them out, to prove the legend, that is. York, the red seeds you have found from those other murders, they all came from this town, together with that one evil. People on the other side of the planet may have heard of it by now, and new seeds might be growing in different parts of the world.
So you're saying that the series of cases I've been following are all linked to this town? That's interesting, Harry. But there's no evidence to support that story. None of the criminals we caught for the other murders ever mentioned anything like that.
It's your job. Your role and duty to look into that, York. Now, the game must go. You know, I said that the incident 50 years ago was totally erased. Well, not quite. Records still exist in the sheriff's office. The old sheriff back then hated the military and did his own investigation. I need you to bring those documents here to me. Once you've done that, I'll tell you everything I know.
Okay, it's worth a look. And we may as well let the old man have his fun.